everyone, it's Kim Dao here. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys the top 10 Japanese hair products. So Japan is known for a lot of really good affordable hair products. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys the products that I researched and found out were the best ones. Of course, these products work differently for everyone. My hair is also very damaged because I bleached it quite a lot. So this is just a bit of reference for you guys. Just before I start this video, make sure you guys subscribe to this channel and thumbs up, and let's get straight onto it. The first item is the Kao Essential Rich Damage Care Treatment. So this is a 30-second treatment which you can use every day. I guess this is more of like a conditioner because you only leave it in your hair for about 30 seconds, and this product claims to help your hair become smooth and more manageable. This hair treatment uses honey, raw jelly extract, and has proteins, and this item works really well for those who have colored, bleached, or damaged hair in general from heat products. For people with damaged hair like mine, this product is a lifesaver. Whenever I shower, if I don't use treatments, my hair becomes really dry and coarse afterwards. I've actually been using this for a few years now. I used the older version, which was the one in the tub. What I find really convenient about this item is that it's kind of like a treatment mask, but you can wash it off straight away. So what I kind of don't like about the masks is that you have to leave them in your hair for about 20 to 30 minutes after you shampoo your hair. So it's kind of awkward because you're going into the shower, washing your hair, then you have to dry yourself off, put on the pack, and then wait around, and then jump back into the shower again. It's kind of annoying. But with this item, you can just shower in one go, and then you'll have soft and silky hair afterwards. Shiseido Mashiri Perfect Shower. This product is really good if you have really bad bed hair. Because I usually sleep on my back, when I wake up in the morning, my hair gets a bit funky towards the back and a bit too crazy for my liking. This product is great to fix that problem. So you just spray this on areas where you feel that needs a little bit of help, and then just brush out your hair, and it just really helps your hair settle down. You can either let your hair air dry or you can blow dry it, and it leaves your hair feeling smooth and looks really shiny. There is a scent to it, but it goes away really quickly. And this product is really light, so it doesn't weigh down your hair. I wash my hair at night time, so if you wash your hair in the morning, maybe it won't be useful to you. However, I don't wash my hair every single day because it makes it more dry. So for days where you don't wash your hair, this would be really handy for that, or for those who shower at night time. And sometimes when you go to bed with your hair a little bit damp, your hair goes crazy, and this helps out so much for that. It's a lifesaver for me. Carl Merritt Shampoo. This shampoo is one of the best Japanese shampoos out there, and it's one of the best-selling shampoos in Japan. This is known for washing out very quickly, so it's great for people on a budget who are trying to save water and trying to save money, or if you're just trying to be friendly to the environment in general. It's actually a foam, so you can massage it into your hair very easily. This product also has extracts to help moisturize your hair. It has eucalyptus extract as well as fruit acids. It does have a light floral scent, which is quite pleasant. Venus Spa Hair Fragrance. Hair fragrances are really popular in Japan. Sometimes when you spray stuff in your hair, especially with hairspray, it doesn't have the best smell, right? It smells kind of weird. If that's the case, I just use a hair fragrance to spray onto my hair, and it just makes my hair smell so much nicer. Also, it really works for some days when I go to Korean barbecue, for example. You come out smelling like your dinner, and it's not exactly the best smell to have on you. So especially the next day, if I don't plan to wash my hair and my hair just smells like beef and pork, then I just use this to spray on my hair, and it just makes it so much better. And not only does it make your hair smell nicer, it does have ingredients such as hyaluronic acid and amino acids to help repair damaged hair cuticles. It does come with a wide range of different scents, but I found this one to be my favorite. Tsubaki Shiseido Extra Moist Shampoo. This shampoo is super popular in Japan. Tsubaki means camellia flower in Japanese, and the oil of that flower is used in a lot of Japanese hair care, and that's one of the ingredients in the shampoo. This shampoo does have different types, but because my hair is so dry, I got the extra moist version. This product claims to gently cleanse and hydrate strands as it enhances hair elasticity, and it also softens your scalp to give your hair more moisture. Since my hair is dry, it does tend to get a bit frizzy sometimes, and after washing my hair with the shampoo, my hair does not look frizzy at all. It's got like a really nice fruity scent to the shampoo. Shiseido Tsubaki Damage Care Treatment. This treatment is for people with damaged, dry, or coarse hair, and like the shampoo, it does have ingredients such as the camellia oil to help with dryness or the split ends you may have. And it also has amino acids, which help strengthen the hair from the follicles. And you can use this as a conditioner, so you can use it every day. But what I generally like to do is use this as a mask. So usually I like to put it onto the ends of my hair, and I leave it for about 20 minutes, and then I wash it off. And I do that maybe once a week. My hair does feel very soft and smooth after this, especially the back of my head, because it tends to get a bit crazy and frizzy back there. But I wouldn't use this every day. I'll just use it maybe once a week. Now, this item is very moisturizing, so if you do have an oily scalp, scalp, I don't recommend you use this because it'll probably make that worse. But if you have an oily scalp but your hair is dry at the bottom, it's probably better just to apply it at the bottom ends of your hair. And like the shampoo, it does have a nice floral scent to it as well. Powkeeper Super Hard Hairspray. Now this hairspray maintains your hair and gives it a soft and bouncy look. I've been using this hairspray for a couple of years now. I usually carry around the smaller version, and it's really good if you have stubborn hair bits that would not stay. This particular one is meant to help keep your hair through rain or wind and your hair will not budge. I usually use this only when I have an updo because it really does hold it very well, but it does make your hair go very hard. Because it does make your hair go very hard, that's how it can hold your hair firmly. I don't use it every day. I only use it if I really want to keep my curls or if I have an updo. But if you're looking for a hairspray that will last a very long time, then this one is it. Ichikami Hair Styling Water. So this item has multi-purposes for your hair. You can use this item to fix your bed head, but I prefer to use it as a heat protectant. Usually before curling my hair, I like to spray this all over and comb it out. And this product makes hairstyling a lot easier for curly or straight hair. And it's meant to firmly set curl patterns and gives you a really nice natural look. And this item also moisturizes your hair, it reduces frizziness, and it also prevents messy hair. Kind of gives you like an effortless look, and it does have like a slight fragrance. And then another thing is that it protects your hair from static electricity. What I also like about this product is that it's got this little pin here. So the pin here prevents this from spraying everywhere. I cannot use it when the pin is in, and it will just sit nicely inside my suitcase. Next is the Oshimatsubaki Camellia Hair Care Oil. This item is super popular in Japan. It's the number one item, and you can find this in a lot of places in Japan. My recommendation is if you go to a drugstore or a Don Quixote, you can find it cheaper than places like Tokyu Hands or Loft. And there are so many ways that you can use this product. You can use it for your hair, and also you can use it to remove makeup and on your body. I'm only going to focus on your hair because this is a hair video. You can use this after showering by towel drying your hair and then applying just a few drops and kind of just evenly spread it and kind of comb it into the ends of your hair. And then after that, just blow dry your hair, or you can let it air dry, and your hair will feel really smooth after that. And if you do it this way, you can do it every day into your hair, and that's fine. You can also use it as an oil pack, which is only recommended twice a month only. So what you do is that you apply into your hair until it's moist before you shower, and then afterwards just wash your hair with your normal shampoo and conditioner, or you can use it to style your hair. So I just use like one or two drops and I put it into my hair every day just to make my hair feel a lot more smooth and silkier. Scalp care can also be done with this product as well. You just take the oil and then blend it into your scalp for about 5 minutes and then you wash it out. It works really well if you have a really dry scalp. Personally, I like to apply this into my hair after I shower because it makes my hair feel really smooth and nice afterwards. And then on some days where I don't wash my hair when I wake up in the morning and I have like a bit of a bedhead, or even like now, I'll put it into my hair just to make it feel a lot more smooth. Last item is a Hair Buron Curling Iron. So many people have been asking me what hair curler I use, and this is the one that I've been using for the past 6 months now. It is amazing and I love it so much. I am so glad that I bought this item. Now I have to tell you guys, this hair curler is not cheap. I got mine in Big Camera for about $250. So if you travel to Japan, you can get tax free on it. Even though it is expensive, I'm all about buying good quality products because you can use them for a longer period amount of time. I don't really like buying cheap products and then damaging my hair and then continuously having to repurchase them. Also, I want to warn some of you guys, I don't know about other countries, but if you are buying this online, make sure you check the voltage before you buy. So even though I live in Japan right now, I'm going to Australia sometime this year, and the voltage is different. In Australia, we use like 220 to 240 volts, and in Japan, they only use 100 to 110 volts. And say, for example, if I plug a 110 voltage item in Australia, which is 220 volts, it will probably either blow up or it could catch on fire. It's dangerous. So if you live in Australia or other countries that use 220 to 240 volts, make sure you check and see if it's dual voltage before you buy. I don't know if you can see, but it says here 100 to 240 volts, which means that this item is good to use in Australia. I believe the US and Japan use the same voltage, so if you live in the US, it's fine. But that's just a warning for those who are buying this online. Okay, now onto the actual product. This is the best hair curler that I have ever used. I found out about this hair curler because I went to number 76 salon in Omotesando, and they use this hair curler, and I thought it was such a good product, so I asked them what it was and I went out myself to buy it. It's great because it doesn't damage your hair even if you're curling it at high temperatures, and it really makes your hair look nice and shiny with the bioprogramming technology. It curls my hair really easily and it's also very long lasting. I can curl my hair and leave it for about 2 to 3 days and it will still look amazing. That's without putting any hairspray in as well. Also, they got a blow dryer and a hair straightener, which I heard is also very good, but I already have a GHD, so I didn't see the point of buying them. But this is the best hair curler I've ever used. As you can see, I curled my hair yesterday and it still looks really nice and effortless. My hair pretty much looked like this when I woke up. I did spray a bit of the Perfect Shower into my hair, but this is what it looks like a day after. That is it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it and found this video helpful. If you guys know of any other hair care products that you can recommend, let me know in the comment box down below, because I'd love to try out more hair care products. Also, let me know down below if you have any other requests for videos. Subscribe to this channel if you have any, and thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Follow me on my social media and my vlog channel, which I'll link down below as well, and I'll see you guys in the next video.